We will look at anterior prosthodontics using angled custom abutment blank and the hyperdent. We need a custom abutment blank with an angled screw channel. We can see that the angle driver fits into this screw hole. Then, the Exocad is used to complete the design to look like this red abutment. After making the NC file using the CAM program, then machining it with the milling machine, the angled hole abutment is produced, as you can see below. We need three things. First, the angled custom abutment. Second, an implant library for the angled custom abutment. We can provide this implant library in a zip file, and you can simply save it under the implant file. Then you need to restart the Exocad in order to use the library to start designing. In the diagram below, there are two types of drivers. One is a hook-typed gold driver that can bend up to 25 degrees, and the other is a silver driver that can bend up to 15 degrees. Both drivers can safely tighten up to 35 torque. The driver that can bend up to 25 degrees is more useful for prosthetics, but there's a slight vibration. Therefore, the less vibrating, smooth 15-degree driver is used more commonly. So having both types of drivers can be very useful. When you load the library in the Exocad, select Custom Abutment. After executing order, the next step is scanning. Usually there's a hole on the side of the scan body. When putting the scan body onto the implant of the main model, this indentation on the scan body should be facing the lingual side to make things easier. If you select the angle from the implant library and save it under favorites only, it'll be easier to select and use next time. For the type of the scan body, I will select the 15-degree B-type. The 15-degree B-type has a screw hole that bends straight towards the indentation of the lingual scan body. As you can see, the angle the angle is pointing towards the lingual. Let's select another one. Type A. Type A has its hole bent towards the 1-7 in the maxilla and the 3-7 in the mandible. Depending on the angle of rotation of the implant, different types will be used. For instance, sometimes 15AC is chosen. The AC type has a screw hole facing the 2-7 in the maxilla and 4-7 in the mandible. Both type A and type AC has their hole facing towards a point, so the A type blank is used for milling in both cases. In this particular case, I will select the B-type since it has a better angle driver accessibility from the lingual side. Next, we will design the inferior structure of the margin. After designing the exterior prosthesis, the next step is designing the abutment. The most important point is to match the fixture axis of the implant and the insertion axis to be parallel so that there will be more space left for the prosthesis on the buckle margin to create a thick aesthetic buckle ceramic collar margin. In this case, the insertion axis is parallel to the screw hole instead of the fixture axis, meaning it has a 15-degree angle, which is not very ideal, but still can be done without too much of a problem. This way, the ceramic on the buckle margin will be thinner and the color of the abutments can show through. Therefore, it is ideal to make the axis parallel to leave more space on the buckle for a thicker and more aesthetic ceramic margin. For the proximal, it is better to form an emergence profile instead of going too deep subgingivally, since that can make plaque management more difficult. We will lower the buckle side for a better color and for the lingual just enough to avoid discomfort. It is better to design the margin with an X-ray. Now that we're done with the inferior design, we will try and make the prosthesis in a one-step process. Select Attachment Remove to make a hole. Select Attachment Remove to make a hole. If we make a hole more lingual than the original hole, we can use the 25-degree driver even though the abutment angle only provided up to 15 degrees. By adjusting the size and move rotation, make a slightly wider screw hole and select Allow Any Change to make the hole. As we can see here now, we have the angle hole custom abutment and an angle prosthesis on top. The screw channel is shown in yellow in this picture. The next step is milling. Inside the red abutment is curved like this. Here, I used the 1.2 hex angle driver. The Torx screw can be purchased individually and can be used to give more angle. On hyperdent, it is easier to mill from registering the angle blank on the implant milling company's library, but it's still possible to mill with the existing blank. Load angle blank on hyperdent. On the translucent angle hole of the angle blank, rotate and adjust the angle hole of the angle abutment STL file that we designed. Adjust the angle custom abutment on the milling zig and select Adjust Axis of Screw Channel, then rotate. We will look more specifically into the hyperdent. We will look at type A, type AC, and type B using the existing blank. Let's look at type A. Adjust the STL to 180 degrees from the indentation facing forward, then click the clockwise rotation. The clockwise direction is based from beneath the abutment, therefore it rotates counterclockwise when viewed from the occlusal surface. For the AC type, set to 120 degrees, then select clockwise rotation. It rotates from at 11 o'clock direction to 7 o'clock direction. A-type abutment is used for both A and AC types, as mentioned before.
앞에서 봤을 때 시계 방향이지. 그 앞면에서 봤을 때는 어떤 거죠? 뭐 이번에는 이제 가장 간단하게
This time we need to rotate 180 degrees clockwise for type B so that it will be facing 6 o'clock direction.
80도 시계 방향으로 돌려보겠습니다. 스크루치는 축에
Like before, we will select 180 degrees.
장비에서
The angles can be different depending on the equipment you own, so it's important to check this by rotating and comparing with the milling zig.